Hello, you're watching Proactive London. BSF Enterprise has recently announced the completion of the reverse takeover of 3D bio tissues. The enlarged group has also been admitted to the LSE. Joining us with more details are non-executive director Geoff Baker, also managing director Shay Connon. Gents, good to speak with you today.
Good morning.
Good to speak to you. Morning.
So, Geoff, let me start with you. How did you first hear about 3D bio tissues?
Stephen, it was a few years ago now where one of our related companies were looking for technology and bioscience opportunities in the UK. And fortuitously, we came across a transaction that ended up being an investment into 3D biotissue. So we were quite interested at that stage of what Shay was doing in regard to tissue and cell templating. It was at that stage related solely to the cornea, and given that we liked what the market had for corneas, to us, we saw an exciting opportunity and invested almost immediately.
Geoff, how will the funding from the listing help with the expansion of this technology?
Well, where we've gone with the cornea is beyond and into other areas of cell and tissue structuring, and that includes skin and lab-grown meat and lab-grown leather. So to enable us to expand into those areas, we've been quite keen to get a bit of money behind 3D biotissue and expand beyond just the corneas.
Shay, let's bring you in here. What's the difference between your technology and other companies that are currently working on lab-grown aspects?
One of the big differences is that we are scaffold-free, so we're not adding cells to a predefined, pre-manufactured scaffold, which in lab-grown meat is often a pea protein scaffold, which is very similar to the scaffold found in the plant-only meat alternatives. We, using the platform technology that we developed at Newcastle University, we instruct the cells to make that scaffold. So they make all the structural parts of the tissue, be it the cornea, skin, or muscle. So that's a big point of difference. We also have been developing for a number of years a serum-free media supplement. So we also have that under our belts. So we're not reliant on animal serum for the culture of cells. Or more specifically, we actually have a product that allows us to culture the cells in the absence of animal serum.
So Shay, what sectors does this platform technology cover?
It covers potentially quite a range of sectors, from medical device with the cornea through to fashion with lab-grown skin into leather, and this new form of meat formation with the lab-grown meat. So there's those three, plus also there's some other additives. Well, we have the serum-free media, which is required in many different markets itself, actually, biologics production, antibody production, cell therapy production, as well as lab-grown meat. They all require serum-free media. And then there's another additive that we've developed along the journey in tissue engineering, and that we've identified that as a potential skin cream supplement. So that could be into the cosmetics markets as well.
Geoff, is there significant market demand for sectors such as lab-grown meat?
Yeah, I think we're sitting in a revolutionary era at the moment. That sounds exciting, I know. But what cell production in this manner is going to change food platforms and food production, it's going to be extraordinary over the next 5 to 10 years. So the growth will be exponential, and we're looking forward to using this technology to get into this industry.
Shay, How about you describe the process of developing lab-grown meat?
Sure, certainly. So you start with a population of cells, and these are highly proliferative cells, and cells with lots of potential to grow. And actually, the technology is agnostic to the source of those cells. So those cells could be from a cell bank, they could be from a taken from a biopsy of a living animal, or they could be from what's so-called induced pluripotent stem cells. So it doesn't really matter where the cells initially come from. It can be from a variety of different sources. Once we have the cells, we can grow them up to a certain number, and at that point we then put them through the platform, which directs these cells. It controls via biochemical and biophysical cues. We actually start to instruct the cells to organize themselves in a way which is familiar to that particular tissue. So we're talking muscle, so for example. So they start to grow and form muscle fibers. And importantly, these fibers are not randomly arranged. They're very tightly packed and highly aligned. And that is how you find them in the normal muscle. And that's a big part of our platform, creating these functional tissues. So once you have this highly aligned tissue, we can create multiple layers of this. And these are combined into a final product. That's really where our, in the presence, of course, of our serum-free media, the CityMix. But that's really where we're focusing on at the moment. That's the technology, aligning cells, producing meat as you know it, 100% meat, scaffold-free. So that's it, yeah.
And when do you hope to produce the first cuts of lab-grown meat, Shay?
Well, we've already produced small amounts because that's all we needed to produce to show and demonstrate that the platform was working in terms of aligning tissues and forming the fibrous meat as you know it. But what we want to do over the next 12 months is create a showcase fillet that has more substance to it and is more recognizable to the everyday consumer and investor as a piece of lab grown meat. And we'll be doing that over the next year.
So Geoff, once that showcase fillet has been produced, what will your next steps be?
Well, we've already been approached by manufacturers, we've been approached by farming groups and agricultural groups, because they're obviously interested in what we're doing in regard to production of meat. We're going to be at the technological end of the industry and be supplying this type of technology to people who are interested in manufacturing and developing lab-grown leather and skin and serum-free media. So we're going to be the supplier of those. And to us, I think there's a great opportunity in this early stage market.
That sounds like exciting times for the company. I hope you'll keep us posted on any developments, but thank you very much for the update today.
Thanks, Liv.
Geoff Baker is non-executive director, Shay Connon, managing director of BSF Enterprise.